Skin grafting is a procedure in which normal skin tissue is transferred to a site of damaged skin. For a split thickness skin graft which requires epidermis with some part of dermis, a dermatome is used which cuts thin slices of skin. For a full thickness skin graft which requires epidermis with entire thickness of dermis, a scalpel is used. Now the damaged area is cleaned by saline and dead tissue is removed. This is known as debridement. Then the graft is placed and is stitched. Ointment is applied and graft is covered with a gauze. Finally, bandage is used to secure the graft in place. Assalamu alaikum. As you already know, this video is about skin grafting, which comes under plastic and reconstructive surgery. The contents of this video include definition of a skin graft, indications and reasons for grafting, classification of skin grafts on the basis of donor and depth of skin, description of split thickness and full thickness skin grafts, skin preparation of the recipient, and lastly stages of grafting. So first of all, a skin graft is the skin tissue without its blood supply, which is taken from a site of normal skin and transplanted to the damaged skin. Now a graft would only be indicated if the damaged skin tissue cannot be closed by secondary intention, where the surgeon leaves a wound open for some time and the wound is able to replace itself by a healthy normal tissue and then the wound is closed. For a detailed description, you can watch my video for wound healing. Now this wound cannot be closed by secondary intention healing, but it must be able to produce healthy granulation tissue at least, because the graft tissue does not have its blood supply, so it is going to require nourishment from somewhere and the granulation tissue would do that. So if granulation tissue is not produced by the wound, then the graft would not survive and we will have to look for some other surgical procedure. Now this type of wounds could include chronic non-healing wounds like pressure sores, leg ulcers, diabetic ulcers, etc., severe burns, skin biopsy, large surgical wounds, and skin infections which have resulted in extensive skin loss. Now on the basis of donor, a graft can be divided into four types. Autograft is one where the graft is taken from one body part to another. Isografts are taken from genetically identical twins. Allografts are taken from same species. A cadaver could be used for it. We can save the graft from cadaver for 21 days at 4 degrees centigrade, but these grafts are usually rejected in a week, so they are good for temporary grafting. And a xenograft is taken from a different species. And on the basis of the depth of graft, it could be divided into a split thickness graft, full thickness graft, and composite graft. Where the skin loss involves epidermis and some part of dermis, we are going to use STSG. But if the entire dermis is lost along with epidermis, then we'll need full thickness skin graft or FTSG. And if some other tissue like cartilage or bone or fat tissue is also lost along with the skin, then we are going to need composite skin graft, which involves multiple tissues. Let's move on to split thickness skin grafts, which are also known as Thiersch grafts after the person who developed it. They consist of epidermis with variable thickness of dermis, and this is why they have limited durability, because the thicker the dermis, the better it will embed itself in the wound. But this will also increase the healing time, and since these grafts are thin in section, they have less durability as compared to full thickness skin grafts, but also a very short healing time. So as we increase the thickness of dermis, the durability as well as the healing time will also increase. These grafts are hairless and do not sweat, and since they are required in thin slices, so large grafts can also be used, and that is why they can cover all wound sizes. But this results in increased graft contraction, because the larger the graft, the more it will contract. They also provide valuable temporary wound closure. Now the donor site that is preferred is inner thigh and buttocks area to avoid any cosmetic objection. And for harvesting the graft, we can use handheld knives, which include galleon knife and veg blade, and the powered skin knives, which is an electrical device and known as dermatome. It cuts thin slices of skin. And after the skin has been harvested from donor site, a dressing is applied, which could either be occlusive dressing like Duoderm or semi-occlusive dressing like Opsite. The difference is only that the semi-occlusive dressing is permeable to air, so it allows the skin tissue to breathe basically. And both these dressings provide moisture to the skin tissue, so the healing is enhanced, and they also prevent infection. Now the full thickness skin grafts, they are also known as Wolf grafts. And they consist of epidermis with entire thickness of dermis. They provide better color and contour as compared to split thickness skin grafts. And since they are taken in deeper sections, they can close a deep wound at the recipient site, but at the same time, they are creating a wound at the donor site. So we prefer a small size to avoid any damage to the donor site. Due to their small size, they also show less contraction, and the donor site can be arms, groin area, front or back of ear, scalp, above collarbone. To harvest the graft, a template is prepared by drawing the shape of graft and copying it on a paper. Then a scalpel is used to cut the graft. Then defatting is done, which removes the fat layer and leaves only the epidermis and dermis layers. These grafts create a deep wound at the donor site, so we need to close it by a primary closure, which is suturing, or by using another graft, which is split thickness skin graft. After harvesting is done and donor site has been taken care of, the skin preparation of the recipient must be done, in which anesthesia is given first and then the wound site is cleaned by saline or an antiseptic. Then the dead tissue is removed, which is called debridement. It can be mechanical, chemical or enzymatic. Then blood flow to the site is stopped by either tying the blood vessels or by giving epinephrine, which constricts the blood vessels. Then the graft is placed on the wound, and for a split thickness it is held by a dressing or by small sutures, and for full thickness it is held by absorbable suture. Bandaging should also be done in case of a large wound. And finally, the stages of grafting, which explains how the graft become part of the wound tissue. Immediately after grafting, a fibrin bond is formed between the graft and the recipient bed. This is known as adherence. Then within 48 hours, it absorbs fluid and nutrients from the plasma of the granulation tissue of the wound. This is called imbibition. After 48 hours, fine anastomotic connections start to form, so blood can directly enter the graft. This is called inoculation. At last, capillaries in growth occur and fibroblasts complete the healing. This is known as completion or maturation. Now the graft tissue has become the normal skin. This was everything about skin grafting. Thank you for watching.